So this human embryonic stem cell line that we've just produced over the last few months is really the first human embryonic stem cell line that has been produced in the state of Michigan. And this was really made possible by the voters in the state of Michigan passing Proposition 2 in November of 2008. So with that happening, we began working toward the derivation of new human embryonic stem cells. In the future, really, now we are set up to be able to make stem cell lines that either are genetically normal or are genetically abnormal. And those genetically abnormal lines will be very important in trying to understand how diseases form and potentially look at ways to treat those diseases over time. These human embryonic stem cell lines that we make that are specific for genetic diseases are envisioned to actually give rise in the future to treatments and cures that will make people's lives better. So as we began this project toward deriving human embryonic stem cells, there was a lot of work that we had to do really in making sure that we were prepared, both from a infrastructure point of view, having the laboratory, having the equipment, but maybe more importantly, we had to really be prepared and make sure that we comply with federal law, state constitution, and one of the important aspects in the regulations was, again, making sure that we comply with the National Institutes of Health guidelines that were set down last summer. And again, by doing that, our hope is that we'll be able to make these lines available for many types of research by many researchers across the country. Our first human embryonic stem cell line that we have derived is entitled UM46. This is a line that we began working on in May of 2010. This is a human embryonic stem cell line that really is derived from a day 5 embryo that was donated to the University of Michigan. We also call these embryos a blastocyst. And from that blastocyst, we're able to isolate a few cells, and from those cells then begin to multiply them in culture to try to derive a human embryonic stem cell line. A human embryonic stem cell line are millions of cells that are derived from a single cluster of cells, those 30 cells we began with from the single embryo. And these human embryonic stem cells have characteristics that are known to be important for a human embryonic stem cell line. They need to be genetically normal, have the right number of chromosomes. They also need to maintain themselves as they grow in an undifferentiated state. However, when you want them to differentiate, they should be able to differentiate into the three different stem cell lineage or cell lineages. And we've identified that that is the case for this cell line. We're very excited to have been able to derive this first human embryonic stem cell line here in the state of Michigan. And this was from an embryo that was normal. In the future, our goal is really to be able to derive human embryonic stem cell lines from embryos that are known to have genetic abnormalities that give rise to specific diseases. For instance, getting embryos that have been tested and are known to be carriers of the mutations that give rise to Huntington's disease, Tay-Sachs disease, cystic fibrosis, Rett syndrome. All of these are types of genetic diseases that we can actually make human embryonic stem cell lines for. And those lines themselves then can be used by many individuals to understand how the disease develops, how the disease progresses, and how we might be able to come up with treatments and cures for those diseases.